U.S. Air Force Research Laboratory plans to test Golden Horde concept later this year, which will allow munitions that are networked to operate together in a swarm and act autonomously. Viewers may note that Golden Horde is one of the three technology development efforts selected by the Air Force in 2019 as a Vanguard program, high-priority prototyping and experimental initiative that the service recognizes as potentially groundbreaking. U.S. Air Force Brigadier General Anthony Genatempo, the service's program executive officer for weapons, had offered the first details about Golden Horde at a media roundtable on the sidelines of the Life Cycle Industry Days at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in Ohio on June 20, 2019. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how U.S. Air Force's Golden Horde swarm will take on Russian and Chinese air defense. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Near-peer rivals of the U.S., like Russia and China, are deploying long-range integrated air defense systems. They're trying to have a strong anti-access area denial (A2AD) set up in place. For example, Russia has developed and deployed S-400 Triumph air defense system, which is considered one of the most powerful air defense systems in the world. S-400 is an air defense weapon system developed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau in the 1990s as an upgrade of the S-300 family. It's been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It's designed to defend against aircraft including 5th-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and ballistic missiles. The radars of S-400 have a range of around 600 kilometers or around 370 miles. The main radar is complemented by target acquisition radars, some of which are touted to have the ability to detect stealth aircraft. S-400 deploys multiple missiles to cover its strike envelope and can take out targets at a range of 400 kilometers or 250 miles, flying up to a speed of Mach 14. Russia is also working on S-500, which will be even more powerful. U.S. Air Force will find it difficult to take out these systems with traditional weapons, and this is where swarming technology will come to the fore. The technology of swarming is in which drones as well as smart munitions will be deployed in squadrons, able to think independently and operate as a pack using artificial intelligence (AI). The concept will allow thousands of independent units to act as one and home in on the target in a collaborative fashion. This kind of capability will be disruptive, as it will be hard to defend against. For example, even the most potent air defense will find it hard to track a single drone or incoming munition from a huge number of potential targets, and it will also run out of ammunition. This technology is in its infancy, but militaries around the world are putting in a lot of resources on this. A relatively simple form of this has already been used. In January 2018, Russian forces faced a drone swarm launched against Khmeimim Air Base in Syria. The Russians were able to neutralize most of these, though the attack was not able to inflict major damage. It indicated that the threat of the swarm weapon had arrived. A relatively recent example is the attack on Saudi Arabia. On September 14, 2019, facilities of Saudi Arabia's oil company Aramco located in the east of the country, came under attack. As per reports, 18 drones and 7 missiles were used for the coordinated attack. The damage was significant, and this caused a spike in global oil prices. It's to be noted that, being facilities of very significant importance, they were protected by layered air defense. The inner layer consisted of several short-range automatic gun systems that were designed for last-ditch defense. The outer layer was Patriot PAC-2 surface-to-air missile batteries that the U.S. sold to Saudi Arabia to intercept aircraft and missiles. In this case, the Patriot air defense failed to neutralize the incoming threats since it couldn't detect them properly or was overwhelmed because of large numbers. Golden Horde will use swarming technology. AFRL, or Air Force Research Laboratory, is working on 2 networked munitions for Golden Horde: the Collaborative Small Diameter Bomb 1, CSDB-1, and the Collaborative Miniature Air Launch Decoy, CMALD. CSDB-1 is derived from the GBU-39B small diameter bomb, which has a range of 110 kilometers or 68 miles against stationary targets, and 72 kilometers or 45 miles against moving ones. CMALD is derived from MALD, which is an intelligent decoy missile having a range of 460 kilometers or 285 miles. The integration of hardware and software on the Golden Horde program is being performed by Scientific Applications and Research Associates, Inc., which won a $100 million contract in 2019 for CSDB-1, and Georgia Tech Applied Research Corporation, which won $85 million for CMALD, Air Force Magazine reported. Norma Taylor, the program manager for Golden Horde, has stated both involve taking munitions currently in production, the laser-guided version of Boeing's Small Diameter Bomb 1 and Raytheon's Miniature Air Launch Decoy, and then outfitting them with new radios that allow the weapons to exchange information, and equipping them with new processors for additional computing power. Colonel Gary Haas, director of AFRL's Munitions Directorate, said AFRL is on track to begin F-16 fighter jet flight tests with the CSDB-1 this fall and winter, with similar tests of the B-52 bomber carrying the CMALD planned for summer 2021. The first tests will be simple and will help the Air Force ascertain whether the weapons are properly communicating across the network and acting in accordance with the mission playbook. For example, a pack of CSDB-1s could come across a threat while on the way to attack a predefined target and would have to change course to avoid it. Norma Taylor stated that a pilot's experience launching the CSDB-1 or CMALD should be about the same as the baseline version of the weapon, with mission planning teams working to pre-program the network munitions with information about its rules of engagement ahead of takeoff. He added, eventually, AFRL will use the CSDB-1 and CMALD together in an integrated swarm in a more complex scenario, currently scheduled around 2022. As evident, the Golden Horde Initiative's focus is on networking existing munitions. This lowers risk proposition than developing an entirely new weapon system, and also reduces development timelines. Golden Horde concept brings in many advantages. For example, few munitions could hit the target and others could send back images to reveal the extent of the damages to the operator, who can decide if more munitions need to attack. Another scenario could see a part of the swarm be designated to hit predefined target, whereas the other part is programmed to take out pop-up threats, such as point air defense systems, and engage them so as to reduce the threat to the rest of the swarm. Though a lot of progress has been made when it comes to air defense, nothing is fail-proof. Even the most advanced system would be disabled if a single munition from a pack of 100 manages to hit one of its critical components, like radar or control center. It's clear that this kind of capability will provide the US Air Force a distinct advantage and enable it to exploit the vulnerabilities of a rival's air defense setup.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.